A mighty fortress is our God, a bulwark never failing. Our helper, he amid the flood of mortal ills prevailing. For still our ancient foe doth seek to work us woe. His craft and power are great, and armed with cruel hate. On earth is not his equal. Did we in our own strength confide, our striving would be losing. Were not the right man on our side, the man of God's own choosing. Dost ask who that may be? Christ Jesus, it is he. Lord Sabaoth, his name, from age to age the same, and he must win the battle. And though this world with devils filled should threaten to undo us, we will not fear, for God hath willed his truth to triumph through us. The prince of darkness grim, we tremble not for him. His rage we can endure, for lo, fail him. That word above all earthly powers, no thanks to them abideth. The Spirit and the gifts are ours through him who with us sideth. So we let goods and kindred go, this mortal life also, the body they may kill. God's truth abideth still. His kingdom is
forever and ever. Amen. the song of freedom. Praise Him for the victory. I'm alive now in the name of Jesus. Praise the great and holy one for all He is and all He's done. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
The word says from the rising of the sun to the going down the same, the name of the Lord is to be praised. Amen? So that's our job. Let's step into it. Here we go.
When the sun comes up, when the sun goes down, I will lift my voice, I will stand my ground, and I will bless the Lord.
When the sun comes up,
when the sun comes up, when the sun goes down,
your face.
Yes, I am.
I will live that your will be done.
I That's our testimony right there tonight. Amen? We are alive because Jesus is alive. We have victory because Jesus is our victory. We have freedom because Jesus is our freedom. We have healing because Jesus is our healing. And that's all we sing about tonight. We sing to Him because He's worth it. We sing to Him our testimony. And I think this song might be your testimony. Sing it with us. Here we go.
Savior came from glory, how He gave His life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about His groaning, of His precious blood's atoning. Then I repented of my sins and I won the victory.
I'm out of breath. But what a better thing to do than to spend the very breath that God gave us right back on Him. With a grateful heart, singing our testimony to Him. His word tells us tonight to enter His gates with what? Enter His gates with what? With thanksgiving. Let's be a grateful people tonight as we worship.
There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your breath melts alone. I've tasted and seen the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord, oh, Holy Spirit, You are welcome. Come.
Chorus again.
Holy
And at the same time, I feel like such a big fat phony. For me to say, your glory is what my heart longs for, to be overcome. But when is the last time we've been truly overcome by the presence of God? And if we ever have before in our lives, and if we have tasted and seen that the Lord is good, then what keeps us from going back? Like, just with a, whatever it takes, God, I want more of you. Whatever it takes, God, make it happen in my life for the glory of Jesus. Overwhelm me with your presence. Cause me to be overcome by your glory. Take care of it, like the pastor said this morning. Amen. Does anybody want to put yourself in that position with God tonight? Anybody just want him, whatever it takes? Whatever it takes. And if you don't want it, do you want to want it? Is there anybody that doesn't want it, but you want to want it? Anybody? Then let's ask for it. Holy Spirit, we come to you. God our Father, we come to you in Jesus' name by the power of your Holy Spirit. And we say, you are welcome here to show the glory of Jesus in us, around us, through us, whatever. And we ask that the true Jesus of the Word, the one who came for us, the one who reigns in perfect power, would speak to us in a way that we would know it was him. And we ask in Jesus' name that the power available to us because of Jesus would be manifest in our lives. We ask for breakthroughs in places where we feel captive, where we feel stuck, where we feel burdened. We pray for an abundance of your love to shower over us, not just for our benefit, but so that we can walk with the glory of Jesus shining through us. And as we worship tonight, we want to say a lot of things. We want to say thank you. We want to say we trust you. We want to say you are worthy of our praise. We want to say we surrender, but perhaps more than anything, we just want to say, we love you, Lord. We love you so much. We love you so much, Lord. Receive our praise tonight, not because we deserve it, but because of your love for us. We give that praise to you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. It's in Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said,
oh, Been here at this church yet, John? Why have you not invited me before? These people are so much more awesome than you said.
That is not true.
That is not true. Oh, listen, I love this guy so much. I was telling the choir this morning, was it this morning we talked? And I said, I think you literally have the best worship pastor of any church. Anywhere. And then I said, I say that to every church I go, but here I mean it. I mean it in the most literal sense. I really do. And you are blessed beyond measure. And this is amazing choir and orchestra and praise team and tech people. It's just been the most fantastic day. Any of you ladies, were you with us in Mobile this weekend? Anybody? Just a few of you. I spend a lot of my life with lots of women. It's like an estrogen fest where I work. I travel with Beth Moore, and we are in our 19th year. I started leading worship with her when I was like 13. Who said, yeah, that was not nice? Just kidding. It's a wonderful blessing to me, and we have, you know, she's coming along as a teacher. She's getting there. She'll grab some passion one day, then she's really going to be something. And so, yeah, I do spend my weekends with thousands of beautiful women and a few brave men, And we have a great time, and we had a great time in Mobile this weekend. I lead worship at a church in Jackson, Tennessee, and they are gracious to let me come and every once in a while slip away on a Sunday and be with people like you, so I'm really grateful to be here. My wife and I, we've been married, we're about to celebrate, a week from today will be our 23rd anniversary, and so very excited about that. 23 years we've been married. We've had 19 happy years of marriage. And I'm kidding, that was a joke. I thought y'all would laugh harder than that. It's kind of an old joke. But I love my wife, Angela, so much. We have three children. My son, Jack, is 19. He is a sophomore in college. And my daughter, Lily, is 16. She just turned 16 last week. So let's pray about that right now. Father, for all those on the road in Jackson, Tennessee, we lift up our prayers. No, that my little Lily is 16, and then I have a son, Levi. My other son is 13, and he's in eighth grade. And, you know, he has gone from smelling really bad to smelling like just straight up Axe. Like, it's just Axe all the way. So I don't know which is worse, but we're going with Axe for now. But I love my kids so much. I'm crazy about them. But I'll tell you, I just want to be real honest, is that I have three children who would make James Dobson cry. Like, he would rewrite the strong-willed child just for my children. But I look at my teachers and I look at their teachers and I go, God bless y'all. You have a great day. We'll see you in 6 hours. They're yours. And don't call me. Don't let me know anything. Just all I know is they're going to be really fun adults. And that's all I got for you. So I'll see you at 3:30. And they are children that love Jesus and they have a fiery passion for life. And I'm grateful to be a dad. I was thinking this week, my son, my 19-year-old, just dropping him off at college again for his second year, and thinking about just kind of going through old pictures this week. And I was looking for pictures for my daughter's 16th birthday, doing a little thing for her, and was looking at my son when he was born in 1997 and that huge bald head on that tiny body, and thinking about him when I would come home from work and he would be waiting at the glass door for me to drive up, you know, when he's just a little over one and just barely learning to stand up and toddle around a little bit and just waiting for his daddy. And he'd get so excited when he'd see me walk through the door and he would clap his hands. He'd get so excited and he'd just fall down on that rear end. That diaper rear end that was great padding, you know, and just would lift up his hands like this, you know, except they came to here back then. You know how babies are, they came to here. But just lift up his hands. And what do you think I did in that moment? I did what any parent would do. I just swept him up, and I just put my nose in his neck, just sniffed him and kissed him. I don't sniff any of them anymore, really, but just there was nothing that was going to keep me from loving on him. And then I think about that, looking at those pictures this week, and I was thinking about the Heavenly Father. Now, do you think that when I was picking him up, I had some kind of entitled spirit or bitter spirit towards my one-year-old because we had spent the whole day taking care of him? Cleaning up his mess, his messes, giving him his every bite to eat, meeting his every need. Do you think I cared one bit? Do you think my wife cared one bit? Maybe she was tired. But we love that boy so much. And he didn't have to earn that love. He didn't have to, in that moment, try to conjure up something to where he could take care of himself. And if we on earth who are comparatively evil parents compared to the Lord, if we know how to love our children somewhat and give good gifts to them, how much greater is the Father? And so I just want to encourage y'all tonight. This is the only thing that you hear tonight. I want you to hear this. Your Heavenly Father loves you so much. He is always for you, and He is never against you. Think about that. There will never be a moment in time when God is working against your behalf. Now, He will create your circumstances to draw you to Him, but it's always for you. It's always rooted in love, and it's always for our good and for His glory. Anybody grateful for that? That's good. Let's sing about that. You might know this. Sing it with us if you do.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night. You tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am.
Oh, when I many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide, 'cause you know just what we need before we say a word. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are.
Who I am.
waits for my answer.
And waits for my answer.
The sacrifice.
The sacrifice.
Is calling me.
Is calling me.
To a life.
To a life.
A total surrender.
A total.
The power of the cross, where mercy. Sinners' name, Jesus.
Let the weak say I am strong, and let the poor say I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. And now, let the weak. For the road that leads from darkness into light, and for the hope that rescues us from endless night, for the grace that covers sin at the door where life begins, for salvation reaching in to guide us through. Thanks be to our God. And for the healing that no mortal can explain, and for deliverance that breaks the sinner's chain, for the strength to carry on, for forgiveness great and strong, and the promise of your mercies ever new. Thanks be to our God. Hallelujah. Our everlasting songs will rise for all done. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thanks be to our God.
For the emptiness that cries out to me, for the promise that your word is deeper still, for the longing and the need to have more of you in me, because nothing satisfies the way you do. Thanks be to our God.
Hallelujah.
Everlasting song.
be to
I'm